Hello everyone and welcome back to the Perfect French with Dylan. Today we are going to learn when to use the imparfait. So we saw when to use the passé composé. Today we are going to focus only on the imparfait. Tomorrow we are going to have a short lesson on when to use them in the same sentence. For today we are going to go on the book from page 147 to 141. So the imparfait is the other tense of the past that we use a lot, just like passé composé. We can translate to two main tenses and two extras. So we have the past progressive. If we say to eat, for example, we'll say I was eating, or the simple past, so I ate. And the two little extras are when you say I used to or I would. In the past, very important, in the past. So all of them can be translated to je mangeais. Je mangeais. Okay? So the imparfait is used to talk about the past, mostly action and situation, without specific time frame. This is very important, without specific time frame. That happened an unspecified amount of time, or when in progress, when something else happens. So in this lesson, we are going to see frequently used words. So the word that you are usually going to find with the imparfait. And we're going to see a few important points about the imparfait as well at the end of the lesson. So we use the imparfait to describe habits and repeated action in the past without being specific in terms of timing. In this type of situation, we have a good chance to find this type of words. So, autrefois, formerly, d'habitude, usually, en général, generally, jamais, never, le lundi, le mardi, on Mondays, on Tuesdays. Of course, it works as well for Wednesdays, Thursdays, etc. Let's see two sentences we have. Autrefois, il était professeur. Autrefois, il était professeur. Formerly, he was a teacher. So this is the verb être conjugated in imparfait. Nous n'étudions jamais. Nous n'étudions jamais. We never studied. So this is the verb étudier that we saw yesterday on how to build the imparfait. When you understand the first point, you can do the exercise 3.5. We also use the imparfait to talk about repeated action in the past that you could translate to used to or would. So some very common words that we use with the imparfait are chaque année, every year, chaque mois, every month, souvent, often, or tout le temps, all the time. Je jouais au football tous les jours. Je jouais au football tous les jours. I used to play soccer every day. Il dormait souvent avec la fenêtre ouverte. Il dormait souvent avec la fenêtre ouverte. He often used to sleep with the window open. So this is the verb dormir, conjugated in the imperfect, of course. After this one, you can do the exercise 2.6. Make sure you have time for this video because not that it's long, it's just you have exercise after each point. We also use the imparfait to describe a person, a property, the weather, or even a physical state or an emotion. Il était grand, il était grand, he was tall. La maison se situait au bout de la rue. La maison se situait au bout de la rue. The house was situated at the end of the street. Or, il pleuvait beaucoup. Il pleuvait beaucoup. It rained a lot. So you can see for none of them, we can really say when it started, when it stopped. Okay? To express emotion and physical state, we also use very specific words that we are going to find with the imparfait, such as aimer, to like, croire, to believe, être malade, to be sick, s'attendre, to expect, or even souhaiter, to wish. You have more examples in the book as well. J'aimais beaucoup le café. J'aimais beaucoup le café. Or, il souhaitait réussir. Il souhaitait réussir. He wished to succeed. So this is very easy. When you want to describe someone or something in the past, usually use the imparfait. When you're done, you can do the exercise 3.7. We also use the imparfait to talk about action happening at the same time, without specific time frame, once again. We have elle rangeait la terrasse pendant que les enfants jouaient. Elle rangeait la terrasse pendant que les enfants jouaient. She was tidying up the patio while the kids were playing. So the two actions happened at the same time, and they were both going on for some time. We don't really know how long. Second one. Il travaillait et elle répondait au téléphone. Il travaillait et elle répondait au téléphone. He was working and she was answering the phone. Okay? Two very particular are after C. We have two very specific cases here. After C, so C means if in English. After C, right away. Si seulement j'avais plus de temps. Si seulement j'avais plus de temps. If only I had more time. But when you have AC, we are also going to use the imparfait, so NF. But it's more as a suggestion. Et si tu venais ce week-end? Et si tu venais ce week-end? What if you came this weekend? So you suggest something, but we are going to use the imparfait. Another one. Et si on se voyait ce soir? Et si on se voyait ce soir? What about we meet tonight? When you're good, you can do the exercise 3.9. Now, the few important points that I said that we will see at the end, I just didn't know how to label them, so let's just start. When we have aller plus the infinitive, if we conjugate the verb in the imparfait, we are going to have j'allais partir. J'allais partir. I was going to leave. Il allait la demander en mariage. Il allait la demander en mariage. He was going to ask her to marry him. So this is just to show you the different way that we build the sentence with the imparfait. Venir de, so venir de is the recent past. To have just. Il venait d'arriver. Il venait d'arriver. He had just arrived. Then we have être en train de. To be in the process of doing something. Nous étions en train d'étudier. Nous étions en train d'étudier. We were studying. They translate to we were in the process of studying. Another one is être sur le point de plus infinitif. To be about to. Ils étaient sur le point de divorcer. Ils étaient sur le point de divorcer. They were about to get divorced. That's it for today. When you're good, you can do the exercise 3.10. So you have quite a few exercises for this one. Tomorrow, we have a full chapter on imparfait versus passé composé. A lot of exercises. So I will see you tomorrow. À demain.